Hey everyone. Can everyone hear me? Okay, right. Let's get started. First thing I want to talk about is the interactive charts in Padlet. Okay, so I'm going to open a slide to all the previous examples we have on chart, which is interactive, but the slide didn't highlight how to actually make it interactive. Let's get out of the way. Okay, right. So we've seen that we've got this is coming back from a tree map palette. If you go to the last few slides on the intraday charts. Okay. So I'm gonna just pull this one in. So my Jupyter notebook. So this is the regular chart that the slides highlighted. Now it's supposed to be interactive, but that's the first example. You can see the data, the feedback comes straight from the soul. So unless you launch this in Python, you can get it to work. Alternatively, you can also download PyCharm. PyCharm is an IDE that allows you to build your Python project. Similar to Jupyter, yeah. So this is a site you can download PyCharm and run it. Now I'm gonna show you a simpler way to get around this because I want to try to keep everything in the notebook. So I think without any additional software, how to keep everything here in the notebook and still my interactive charts. Okay, so I'm gonna go on to the second part of the example. Now the second part of the example actually defines some kind of a text label that will display. So I'm gonna just remove this here. So the second part of the example is like actually hooks up the press and release event. She will show you the where you clicked on the chart and on of release, it removes the text of the plot. So let me run this one. So obviously it's not interactive. Okay. So I'm gonna add a line here. Okay. Right. Now this line I add here is something like a command to tell to actually enable interactivity for charts. Right. Okay. Now, immediately you see the difference is you have this kind of control bar to store iteration. And if you try to click in the chart itself, it gives you directly the feedback. Okay. So, if you want to have some basic Python interaction in the chart, like if you click on the line, it gives you the value on the line chart. You could actually do this, right? So this is the magic sort of magic line we include in the block of screen. Yeah. Okay. Okay. So now with that out of the way, I'm gonna move on to the lab materials. Download the app materials for this. Sorry. Okay, let me repeat. Okay, see my screen now. Oh, totally forgot to share my screen. Right. So come back to the utility charts. So referring back to matplotlib slides 61 to 64. So basically lifted the code from here into my Jupyter notebook. Right. And then change the onclick and offclick event to the one from slides 64 here. Okay. Now I added a line on top, which is this. Okay. Let me remove that line. So what some of you encountered is if you render the plot, you get. Okay. Let me just. So this is the non-interactive plot, just a picture. Line view has some interactions, handle a mouse click, and press and release. Press means when you click your mouse down, release if you release the button. Add the design on top, then run it. Okay. Now the chart has a couple of interesting additions. So stop interaction bar. Scroll down, there's some other views. And if you click in the chart, the click events will be handled. So which means you can have a button to modify the data range, perhaps, or to click and highlight the particular values, Y values on the chart. So we'll come back to the line here. Okay, by the way, the session is recorded, so I'll upload the recording on YouTube and send you guys a link. So as much as I try to do is to keep everything in the notebook rather than try to explore too much ways to like run off the command line, store an ID like this PyCharm. Okay. Right. So with that, I'm gonna move on to the lab. So the Panda Labs, right. Okay. Me here should create a folder. And then put all the data sets into data folder. Okay. Here. Close this too. Okay. What's that? Okay, so here we are at the lab. Okay, so there are a couple of exercises here, which is relational series, using data frame, ways of creating data frame, viewing the data. Okay, I think you can do that as exercises on your own. What I'll focus on would be, are there any task to submit. I think so there should be, right? Submission worksheet. So task 3 subset columns. Okay. This guy. The other one. Okay, so let's see. A section 6. This is section 6, right? Task 3. Okay, right, so you do guys have any problem on this task? Ask is pretty simple. It's just the Excel file to read, so you do read Excel. Set the index column as variables, which is coming from the Excel table, and pick up the find out how many rows on the data in any column that values more than 500,000. Right. Okay. So first of all. The question is, do you guys have any problem here? Not really. Okay, so finding rows, first of all, you choose one column. Next, filter the rows, which is the variables that have values more than 500k. Okay. Is the kind of output. Of course, the kind of rows has more than 500k and less than 500k. That's the ask. Okay, so. I'm thinking I don't need to actually use a compiler here. This is my file. So first of all, you know, this is Excel file. So let me create my data frame. So in an Excel file, you will just submit that to Excel. So I put everything in my data folder. So, of course, here's... Okay. So here roughly the data will look like. So you can take a quick inspection, you'll notice the... The columns are actually based on years. I think this is actually a pretty good example. I have to do the pivoting. Yeah, this is a good model. This is a good exercise for doing. This is good data for doing pivoting. But however, the ask here is not. We're gonna pull out one column called 1980, and then figure out the more than less than 500. Okay, so now. So, if I have created a PDF frame for 1980, how do I get to 1980? Okay. Well, first of all, it is best to create, of course, you should create a new data frame based on this. Just print the PDF 1980. And it's immediately you get this data, which is exactly what you have in the 1980 column. Okay. So, now remember data frames are referenced by column, so you can do this immediately to pull out the column for data frame on it. The next thing is to pull out the how many of these values is my part, right? Because I think in the here there's also like the name of the support column, the type, right? The values of more than 500k, less than 500k. Okay. So, I'm trying to find out if something like this. Yeah. Now, if you do this, what you notice is that, okay, so remember how list actually a reason in Python is data frames are NumPy and the arrays behave. So we can apply a condition like this. So, one way to think about it is to count or true or false. Okay, that always gives you the two answers here. Okay. So, you count about true and false. Now, this gives me a Boolean index. So, if I want to have like a filter version of the data, right? Size. So, this is more than 15. See, I shouldn't be taking more numbers here. Go to the slides. Subsetting. Okay, so did that. So question is, thank you. length. Is this length? Yeah, I can use length. Length inside the box. I'm going to take that when you're actually filtering into. So the first parameter is always. The second part is. This is another game behind it. This or this. I think if you essentially choose the other way, it's yourself. And you can also use the other side. Okay, so right. On to the next pass. Specific colors that were characters to Overwatch. Okay. So this is in the power. Now we want the 201X. Okay. Color. So two shadow, basically. So you're choosing this. So this guy. This is the one we can use as a function. Okay? So we should use one matching strings of the this version of the strings that we use the carrots. How do we use this filter? So the regular expression for this is using the carrots. We can use a filter method in the diagram, passing the correct rejects, so that this basically starts with 201. Plus 4. Going on to the subset rows. Task number 3. So here, subsetting rows you use a lot. Choose the row data. Here, the book. This one. Alright, from the CSV file. So, CSV. Let's see. Okay, month, the first column. So, let's set the index. We use a lock to select rows from method 2. Yep. Okay. And display the method. Yeah. We have 2. So A2 would be. Right. So this is definitely has more data than the A2s. Okay. We're only interested in all those. So how does this work now? So now you're choosing the row, right? So it's kind of like blowing down. Okay, I'm just trying. So when I say lock, start from this and to this. Right. So this is data, if this is data sort of order, this is not data. It's not data order, selection of rows. So this is first task. Now if you want to display something called line chart, right? So this is the report for you. So, dropping missing reviews, we don't have it in the current, I think we did cover it in the last lecture. So, we'll cover that next. Task 3. Hold on, so it's a task 3. So this is rainfall management. For time. So what I get rid of here, this is sort of Okay, so we can sometimes specify the course of the setting, reduction of soil, and return to the start of the different forms. And this can shoot.
I mean, if they order It's like it's so honestly if I had
extra. It's a peanut.
Oh, okay, thanks.
Thank you. Oh my god, I'm gonna zombie like